Hey everybody, this is Dr. Michael Shearer. In this training video, we're going to be talking about how we measure the soft tissue depth for our locator angled abutments. In this video, we want to go ahead and take a look at how we go ahead and measure that soft tissue depth and then translate that into ordering the correct locator angled abutment. So I set up right in front of me an example of a patient where we've gone ahead and we've got four implants in position, and the two back implants have a little bit of angulation that we need to correct. Additionally, it's helpful for you to go ahead and have your locator angle technique manual, either in PDF form or in physical form, in front of you to help you with this additional training video to follow along. Let's dive right in. So as we open up our technique manual here, we can go ahead and open up to page number 8. On page number 8, we're going to start out here with step number 1, which is placing our angled locator abutments. So what we generally recommend is when the patient comes in, typically they're coming in from an oral surgeon's or a periodontist's office or an implantologist with healing abutments in place. And it's really ideal to go ahead and help guide with the angulation of the implant at this stage in utilizing the healing abutments with a driver and the locator angle driver. Again, this is helpful to go ahead and guide you on should I use a standard locator or a locator angled. Then I'm going to go ahead and unscrew and remove the healing abutment, and I'm going to have on my side a periodontal probe or instrument to go ahead and measure the soft tissue depth all the way around my angled implant. And what we've got in front of us here now is we have a simulated patient, a periodontal probe. And our simulated patient is essentially a patient that comes in looking very similar to this, where we want to put on straight locator abutments in the front and locator angled in the back. And these implants in the number 22 and 27 position have had implants properly or parallelly placed, and then we were placing tilted implants to avoid critical anatomy here in the posterior portion of the mandibular arch, such as avoiding the mental foramina or the mandibular nerve, where we need to now angle correct for that 15 degree of implant placement. So I've created this model to go ahead and make it easy for us to go ahead and follow along. So step number 1 is we need to go ahead and measure the relative angulation of these implants. I don't have healing abutments for this particular case since I've already removed them, but you can take a periodontal probe, kind of place it into your implant, and just kind of get a general idea of what your angulation is, as well as general idea of what your angulation is. So I can see here I've got about a 15 degree tilt here, as well as it's pretty parallel right here. Now, the proper way to measure soft tissue depth for your locator angled, let's go ahead and backtrack a little bit and talk a little bit about how to measure your soft tissue depth for your standard locator abutments. I have additional training videos available online on my YouTube channel to go ahead and review those core fundamental concepts. I'll take a brief moment to go ahead and review how I would do that for my non-angled locator, as it would make understanding the measurement for my locator angled much easier. So for my standard locator abutments, meaning these two here in the front, I would take my periodontal probe, depending upon the gradations of my periodontal probe. My probe here has 1, 2, 3, and 5 millimeter measurements, and the bottom of that little black band right there is 4. So this allows me to go ahead and take this in here as I place this. My goal is to go ahead and place my periodontal instrument here just at the edge of where my platform is for my implant. So as I do that, I'm going to then read off what my periodontal probing depth is. So right in here is going to be 2 millimeters. I'll jump to the facial. It'll be 2 millimeters. And then as I jump to the distal, it goes up a little bit. I can see here I've got 2.5 millimeters right there. And then on my mesial, I've got 2.5 millimeters right in there. So that means here on my tooth number or implant at the number 22 position, I want to order a 2.5 millimeter locator abutment to match the soft tissue depth of that 2.5. Now, since I'm utilizing an internal hex 3.5 millimeter connection, they do come in half millimeter increments. Some other implant systems for my traditional locator abutments come in solid 1 millimeter increments. So just as a guide, if my soft tissue depth is slightly taller than that 2 or 3 millimeter measurement or that 2.5 or 3.5 millimeter measurement, it's generally a good idea to err on the side of slightly taller for my locator and locator angled abutments. Let's move on to our distally placed implant so that way we can show you how we then take that core fundamental technique and apply it to locator angled. So as I take a look here at my distally placed implants, I'm going to go ahead and measure starting out here on my lingual here. So I can see here I've got my 2 millimeter measuring depth here. And then on the buccal or facial, it's another 2 millimeters. As I come here to the mesial, I can see here I've got 2.5 millimeters. And then on the distal, I'm measuring 3.5 millimeters from the edge of that platform. So what happens now is when I take a look at my technique manual, Zest recommends choosing the highest of those measurements. And it's typically going to be in the most distal position or depending upon where your most angulation is. So what happens now is, this is in the mandibular arch, typically it's going to be in the distal, but sometimes on the maxillary it could be in another position such as the mesial or distal or wherever your tilt occurs. So be careful, because what happens is I want to measure on the long surface of where that locator angled abutment is to give me the proper angulation correction. Now as we go ahead, we take that measurement now and we go ahead and apply to ordering for our locator angled abutment. All of my locator angled abutments come in 0.5 millimeter increments, starting at 2.5 all the way up to 7.5. So I would take that most distal or most angled position. I would then want to order my locator abutment to match that position. So if my soft tissue depth in this scenario is 3.5 millimeters, I'm going to order a 3.5 millimeter cuff height for my locator angled abutment. So that way it positions the top portion of my locator angled at the perfect height. You don't need to add an additional 2 millimeters to the top of your locator angled to be able to go ahead and measure the total height of your abutment. Because what happens now is that when we order our locator abutment cuff height to match my soft tissue depth, it automatically puts that top 2 millimeters or so of the locator snap above the soft tissue. So meaning that the total abutment height will be taller than that soft tissue depth. Zest makes this easy. Now that part is a little confusing, I'll admit, but Zest makes this easy. When you measure your soft tissue depth, you order a cuff height from Zest or from your implant company to match that soft tissue depth. Everything else is already built into the system. So everybody, this is Dr. Michael Shear on an initial video here on how we go ahead and we measure soft tissue depth for our locator angled abutments.